Let us imagine a rough inclined plane having angle of inclination theta with the horizontal. Let the length of inclination is L and the height of the inclination is H. Let the body starts from the state of rest from the top of the inclined plane, and we would like to calculate by the time it has reached the bottom what is the velocity acquired by the body. I would like to say, being a rough inclined plane, as we have already proved in the previous post, that the body will acquire acceleration A equal to g of sin theta minus mu cos theta, where mu is nothing but the coefficient of friction. And bear in mind that the angle of inclination is more than that of the angle of repose. That's why the body is slipping down itself, because mg sin theta is dominating the frictional force. We can apply the equation of motion to find the final velocity, a popular equation of motion, v square minus e square equal to 2as, where u is the initial velocity, v is the final velocity, a is the acceleration of the body, and s is the displacement. By substituting the known data, we have to calculate v square, u square equal to 0. We know that a equal to g of sin theta minus mu cos theta, and s is nothing but the length of the inclined plane. Therefore, we can say velocity of the block by the time when it has reached the bottom is under square root 2gl of sin theta minus mu cos theta. This is the formula for the velocity acquired by the body by the time it has reached the bottom of the inclined plane by covering a length, L, entire length of the inclined plane. If suppose in a problem it is given that if the surface is smooth, the meaning of the surface of the smooth we know quite well. We have done this many times in the previous parts also, that coefficient of friction is 0. Then the body will have an acceleration A that is equal to only g sin theta. By putting the equation coefficient of friction 0 from this equation, equation of the acceleration, just put mu equal to 0, then we will get A equal to g sin theta. Correspondingly, the final velocity acquired by the body by the time it reaches the bottom also will change, and we can calculate the final velocity as root 2gl. There is only a sin theta component, and the mu component and the cos component will automatically become 0. Suppose if you want to express it in terms of the height of the inclined plane, we can write from the diagram that sin theta, look at the diagram, this is the right angle triangle. So sin theta is just opposite side by adjacent side as per the basic definition. So we can write sin theta as equal to h by L. By substituting this value, final velocity will become root 2gl. Sin theta is h by L. I can cancel L and L, and velocity equal to root 2gh. If we have studied the kinematics a little bit, this is nothing but the velocity acquired by a freely falling body from a certain height h. That means if there is no friction impact, doesn't make a difference whether the body is falling from a particular height on an inclined plane or falling straight.